The Department of Surgery here at the University of Utah is uniquely focused on delivering high-value surgical care. We've been ranked in the top 10 amongst academic medical centers for delivering high-value, high-quality care over the past 10 years in a row. Here in Salt Lake City, we're the only academic medical center, so we see all of the most complex cases and patients from our five-state catchment area.
Well, as the only academic center in the state of Utah, we draw on a lot of different learning environments to augment the education of our residents and fellows. So not only are they working at the university hospital, but also participating in care at the only comprehensive cancer center in the state of Utah. Then in addition to that, the VA in Salt Lake City is very close by. And the Intermountain Medical Center has hospitals in the region to which our residents go for additional training.
I was very surprised actually when I came with the broad variety and diversity of patients that we see. We are working very hard with a strong focus on our diversity of our own trainees and our own faculty so we can make sure that we provide the proper care for the community that matches the physician population. Because studies have shown that people connect better with physicians that are similar to them.
The faculty really looks upon the residents and students and fellows as part of the team, that we recognize that, that the way that we've built the delivery of surgical care at the University of Utah is one that isn't reliant on a single person, that everybody makes a critical contribution.
The program here at the University of Utah, we offer absolutely everything you need clinically. You're going to see the full range of patient care, the most complex patients, and the most straightforward. You're going to come away with fantastic open and endovascular skills, and throughout that training, you'll enjoy the benefit of strong relationships with your faculty, with the PA team, with your other fellow, the residents here, and you know, wonderful work-life balance with great things to do in the area and ease of travel to visit family. So it's really the full package.
Our numbers in terms of our aortic volume, I think, is in the 90th percentile for doing open cases, and that's one of the strengths of our program is that we're not just doing all of our big aortic cases using endovascular technology, we're still using open technology and doing open repairs, and that's one thing that a lot of trainees around the country are really struggling to get their numbers in, is doing big open aortic cases, and so that's something that we do offer that's an advantage over other programs.
I think for a fellow who's training, being able to not just have one singular sort of experience, not just heavy endo, not just heavy open, it's good to have a balance between the two, as well as a high volume of bread and butter vascular surgical cases. That's the main reason why I would say this is a great place to train.
We really have a focus on learning the decision-making process for being a vascular surgeon. You know, obviously learning how to operate and learning how to do the technical aspects of a vascular surgery case are important, but also learning, you know, when to operate, but also when not to operate is one of the essential things that we focus on. And we commit a half day a week just to talking about decision making and the didactics of vascular surgery, which I think is a fairly unique process.
The volume is high, the caseload is high, the complexity is high, and I think all those things are going to really help prepare you for what's next. And then certainly you can't scoff at what Salt Lake City has to offer as far as outdoor recreation and just in general a great place to live. So I think the combination of both those really shows that there's just a lot of draw and a lot of great reasons to come here.
We really value building meaningful relationships with our trainees as we get to know you as a person and the whole you outside of the hospital, not just the vascular surgeon. That builds trust, and as we build trust together, we can entrust you and give you autonomy in the operating room.
I oversee our surgical population analytic research core, which is called SPARC, which is a repository for a number of large databases. We also have access to programmers and statisticians, and all of these resources come together so that the fellow, when you have time outside the operating room and you want to get research done, we have all the resources that you can plug in and be able to execute these projects in a fairly efficient manner.
I think that the program here, having one fellow per year, really affords you the opportunity to get that specific focus from the attendings. They get to know you very, very well, and they're entire focus is on you and your training.
So people at the University of Utah, we recognize that being a fully rounded human being involves not being in the hospital all the time. And so when the day is up, people get out. It's incredible that from the front door of the hospital, within 30 minutes, you can be at the foot of some of the best skiing in the world. And down in the south part of the state, some really outstanding, spectacular national parks.
As a surgical trainee here in the Department of Surgery, the opportunities to really develop your career in addition to your clinical skills are extensive.
Not only are we learning how to be great surgeons, technically, and in terms of our knowledge, but learning how to work in an environment that's actually improving the value of the care that we provide to patients that isn't satisfied with the status quo.